Twitty on the Mississippi. Welcome aboard for a riverboat trip to the homeland of Conway Twitty with Conway's special guests, Dick Clark, Jerry Lee Lewis, Charley Fry, Loretta Lynn, Tammy Wynette, George Lindsey, Ralph Emery.
To help you any way they can. My daddy was a Mississippi River man. My mama was a lady from the heart of the land. They taught me how to love the Mississippi mud. There's Mississippi water flowing in my blood, yeah.
About this Mississippi River so much. I can't believe I'm standing here with Conway Twitty talking about it. But it sure is a long ways from Butcher Holler, Kentucky, where I come from.
It may be in miles, but not really, because we grew up a lot alike. We both had hard times, and we had some good times, and people were a lot closer back then. Our whole world was our hometown, and we didn't have any roads back then. All we had was mules and wagons. In fact, that's how we got to town.
Do you ever get back to Friars Point?
Yeah, I do. I go back every chance I get. Of course, my mom still lives there. And you know how it is when you're traveling on the road and doing shows. Nothing feels as good as going back home.
On here, this was a duplex
right,
back then.
Right.
We lived in this side over here, and some other folks lived in the other
side.
And the old church.
Kelly Church is right back over there.
Right over there. You want to hear some top-notch singing, all you gotta do is go out there and sit on that ditch bank. And on Saturday nights, we'd all get together at Grandma's house and listen to the grand
sure
old opera.
Yes, sir, we sure did.
Of course, Dad was a pilot on a riverboat.
Right.
Used to sit up there in the pilot house with him.
He picked a guitar.
Oh, yeah, he did. He taught me a few chords.
Right, yeah.
And got my first guitar when I was about four.
Yeah.
I still got it.
Yeah, about $1.29.
$1.29.
$1.29, right.
I don't remember what kind of guitar it was, but I remember unraveling wire off the screen door and putting it.
Yeah, when you couldn't get to where they were.
When you couldn't get them Gene Archer guitar strings.
Yeah.
It was about 10, I guess, 10 years old. We moved from Friars Point here to Helena, Arkansas. But I still enjoy coming back here.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes this old farm feels like a long lost friend.
Yeah, we're right back here again.
We're going to drop in and see Robert Lawrence for a few minutes.
Yeah.
You remember back when I was 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, along in there, we used to come out here and we saw our first movie on the set. Is that the first one you ever saw, too?
I think so. I think it was.
Right on the side of this building out here in the open.
Mm-hmm.
Bob Steele, I remember that.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they used to have the little carnival things out here.
Yeah.
Had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And then they moved, they came in and put an actual picture show here, what we call it, picture show, right?
Yeah.
And I remember one Thanksgiving when they had a prize that you wanted. They happened to draw your ticket.
Right.
Two prizes, in fact. They had a turkey.
And a set of dishes.
And a set of dishes.
Right.
And you remember who won the turkey and who won the dishes?
I think your daddy won the dishes and I won the turkey.
That's right.
And while he was gone out to take the dishes to the car,
you won the turkey. That's right.
So we had to go back again.
Yeah, we had a big day. We had a great Thanksgiving, didn't we?
It's
go and see Robert Lawrence
for a minute. To be back home again.
Conway, you and your mama wore each other out walking all over town. And you had to do a show that night. And I bet you're going to tell me you wasn't tired.
Oh, I guess I should have been, Loretta. But you know how it is when you play your hometown, it's a little bit special. And it just, I kind of was looking forward to it.
Conway, are we going to stand here and talk about playing shows, or are we going to go over and play shuffleboard? Which one's it going to be?
Well, you just shuffle on over here with me, and I'm going to show you how to play this shuffleboard game, all right? You just step right over here, and I'm going to hand you this stick, and you already know what to do with it, right?
I'll put this one back up here, don't I?
All right. I'm going to bet you a quarter that I'm going to beat you, all right? All
you got to
do is put it on that number down there, right? Yeah. Put it on 10 if you can.
I'll do it.
10 off. Ah, little too much muscle on there, right? Here I go. What'd I do?
Too much muscle, just about.
Too much muscle.
Roll on, Mississippi.
All right.
I know you guys were part of the audience out
here. Oh, yeah, man. You know, I love that song.
It's a good song.
It's a beautiful song.
Listen, there's been a lot of good music written about that old river.
Yeah, that's true, Charlie. And you know, there's a lot of good writers and singers that come from the state of Mississippi, too.
Right.
Well, good friends of yours and mine, people like Elvis.
Right.
And Tammy Wynette.
Oh, yeah.
Jerry Clower. And Charley Pride. Well, John, you know, Charley was born and raised not too far from where we were.
Yeah, I knew that.
And as Charley knows, I was born in the state of Mississippi, too.
That's right.
When I was about 10 years old, I moved up the river about 10 miles over into Helena, Arkansas.
Yeah.
And I was doing some singing back then, but like you, I couldn't find nobody to listen to me back then. Long about that time is when I ran into old John here, and he's been with me ever since.
That's good.
Yeah, that's when we had our first band called the Phillips County Ramblers.
Oh.
Even had our own radio program, KFFA.
That's right. It was hot stuff, boy. That's all we cared about back then, was picking.
That's all you cared about was music?
Well, you know, that's 90% of what we cared about.
What percent of that was baseball?
Baseball was 90% of it, too. Well, you know, I played some baseball back then.
Back then?
John, you know what he's ribbing me about. A couple of weeks ago when we was playing ball out there in Helena.
And
we was out there playing because my son Jim wanted to play.
Yeah. Right. I used the same excuse myself. I just playing ball because my son wanted me to.
Hey, Conway. Hi.
Hey.
Hey, Frankie.
Oh, Charley.
Hi.
Hey, John.
Hey, Charley. How you doing?
Fine. How you doing?
Good to see you.
Well, thanks.
Think fast, Charley.
Oh. Hey. I got it.
Still pretty good.
Hi, Conway.
What are you doing here, man?
I heard you had a show in Clarksdale, son. I heard you were here, and I thought I'd stop by and holler.
Well, that's super. You know my son, Jim?
Hi, Jim.
Oh, Charley.
Fine.
You know John?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
You kind of grew up around here, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. I was born in Friars Point, Mississippi, but I grew up here in Helena, Arkansas, and spent a lot of time out here on the baseball field. Hey, I know you like baseball.
Yes, sir.
In fact, you had a... You got on up there pretty
well. Well, close as I got with the majors, getting to the majors was with the California Angels in 1961. So I about long enough to get a cup of coffee,
I think we made the right choice.
I think so.
Yeah. Country music. And speaking of country music, you see that little nightclub right back there?
Yeah, I was
on
watching.
The other side of the fence?
Yeah.
It used to be called a Copper Cup.
Yeah.
Of course, it's right here by the ballpark, just a couple of blocks from my house. And when I was 10, 11, 12, and 13, I used to sneak over here.
Yeah.
On Saturday nights. And there was a jukebox right inside the door there.
Yeah.
And I'd sit out there on that ditch bank and listen to all them Hank Williams records.
Right.
Inside the door.
Right.
Everybody in there was having a ball and dancing, and I was sitting out there listening to Hank Williams. John just happened to have his dobro here, and I got my little guitar. Would you crank up and maybe sing a little Hank Williams song with us?
I'd love it.
If John would go get his guitar?
I'd love it.
John, you want
it? All right. Do it.
We'll do it. We'll do it like we used to.
All right.
Hey, the pay's cheap. We'll have a lot of fun. Oh, yeah. Good fun, Charlie.
Say, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?
Hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe that we could find a brand new recipe? You'll have to take him here, Charley. I forgot the word.
I got a hot rod board and a $2 bill. I know a spot just over the hill.
Yeah.
We gonna cook and the clobbers still. If you wanna come along, have fun with me.
Say, hey, good looking, what you got cooking?
Oh, yeah.
How's about cooking something up with me?
Oh, here you are, Conway. Didn't you hear that landing bell ringing?
Landing bell? I thought it was school bell.
A school bell?
Yeah, well, you know, it could be. Louisiana's right across the river here. And some of my friends are here that I went to school with in Louisiana. In fact, we're going to have our class reunion right here on the boat today. And, I was a senior at Tallulah High here.
Conway, this is the third place on the Mississippi River that you told me you grew up. You didn't grow up on the Mississippi River. You grew up all over the Mississippi.
I know, but come on. I want you to meet some friends of mine. In fact...
Are you sure?
Yeah, they're all here right now, and they're getting ready down here for our class reunion. And those folks from THS are going to show you how to have a class reunion and do it right.
Really?
Super folks. Look who's here.
That's my good buddy, George.
Yeah, well,
George, would you like to meet my friends here?
Like to. I'd love to.
Well, all right. This is Ray Gardner.
Ray,
how you doing? This is Sonny Clark.
Hey, Sonny.
And this is Annette.
How do you do?
George.
Nice to see you.
George, would you take care of everything here for me? I got to go do something.
Would you mind doing that?
Well, I'd love to.
All right, I'll leave y'all with it. I'll see you later.
Bye, Conway. Come here, come here. Now, all this trip, Conway's told us a ton of lies about what he did at Tallulah High School. Said he played baseball, basketball, football, ice skating, throwed corn cobs. Said he was the most popular boy in the senior class.
Yep.
Loretta and I want to know the real stuff. What is it?
Oh, man, yeah, he was. Look at here, right here at the end.
Yeah.
See right there?
Oh. Most
popular boy.
Hey, George, I told you.
I hate Conway.
Some reunion, Conway.
I knew you was gonna like it.
I really did, but you know, there's something that bothered me. Going back to all the places that you said you grew up just wears me out. And you're just about halfway through all your stories. Have you got anything, any more stories that I don't know about you want to tell me?
Let's see. As a matter of fact, there is this one story. Loretta, you hear what I said? You remember that bus you used to come to New York and Philadelphia, that great big thing, you and Judd?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they'd cruise around Manhattan Island in this big live-in bus. Yeah, I've heard more about you today, and I've known you for 112 years now. I didn't realize that you were going to play for my team, the Philadelphia Phillies. It's my hometown.
I know. Yeah, I had a chance to sign with the Phillies at one time, Dick. And
Philadelphia Phillies?
Yeah, the Philadelphia Phillies. In fact, they almost drafted me, but the Army beat them to it. The Army drafted me, so I went to Japan for a couple of years, and when I got back, the first thing I heard when we got back to San Francisco, I think it was.
Yeah, Elvis Presley.
Yeah, that's right.
Did that change your plans?
Oh, that changed my plans a lot. Yeah, I thought, well, I'd never considered music as a profession up to that point, although I, like Jerry, I'd sing all my life, you know, as a hobby. But it's something I thought I could do. Elvis sang the gospel country and blues thing, and that's what Jerry and I grew up on. So I thought, well, I think I can do that. So I threw down the baseball bat and picked up the guitar, and I've been doing it ever since.
Well, you didn't do too bad, brother.
No, I'm hanging in
so
there.
So much for the Philadelphia Phillies. Wait a minute. You told me you headed for Sun Records. Now, that was the home of Elvis and all the rest of you. Why would you go there?
Well, until I went to the Army, I'd never been north of Helena, Arkansas. Now, Memphis is about 80 miles north of Helena. But I thought Sun Records was the only label there was. Elvis was on it, and Carl Perkins was on it, and Johnny Cash was on it.
Weren't you on it at the same time, or was that later?
Eventually, I got on it, yes.
Just shortly after that, Jerry Lee showed
up. I was the last one on.
Where'd you first run into him?
Oh, you hadn't heard that story. I'm ashamed to tell this story. We won't tell anybody. Well, Sam Phillips called me in one day, and up to this point, I had just been doing demos. You know how we did. Well, yeah. He didn't do too much of that. He walked in there and sang him one song. But I cut a lot of stuff with Sam, and I never did wind up with a contract with Sun. But Sam said, I got this guy walked into my office. This cocky dude came in here and told me how great he was and what he could do. And he said, I want you to hear what he did. And he put this tape on and this song played. And I listened to that. And it was an old country song, you know, dear to my heart. And this guy had taken this song and put this boogie-woogie to it. I said, oh, my, Sam. You know, this guy will never make it. This guy right here. And that song went on to become a gigantic smash. And of course, he went on to become one of my all-time favorite artists.
So much for your career as a music critic.
That's true. Never try to pick them anymore. Hey, Jerry.
You want again?
Yeah, would you mind doing a little bit of that for Dick and I, just for old time's sake?
Did I boogie woogie?
Yeah, a little bit. I thought it was.
Do you remember it?
You, Jerry Lee.
Ball of fire.
Look about it, Mickey.
bad for a country boy in the morning, man.
That's fantastic. Oh. Vic, can you believe that that's the song and this is the man that I predicted wouldn't make it back?
Would you like to make a retraction now?
I'd love to have it back. I'd love to have it back. He's something else.
Well, he had a long string of hits, right?
Yeah, he sure did. He had a string of hits about as long as this Mississippi River that we're on right now.
You didn't do too badly either. Now, what I'd like to do, though, I love this. This is the part I really like. I'm going to take you back. Are you ready? Back to your baby pictures.
Oh, back.
Stand by.
Jerry, watch this.
Look at this.
I like that one.
You remember that?
A long time ago.
Oh, you were young.
And pretty.
You like that?
The
thing I love about it, they bring back some many memories. You guys got to sing together, do something. I mean,
I'm getting that old feeling too. In fact, Joel Killer and I might tune up tonight and do something.
You got it.
Yeah.
How the reaction of the women, you know, when Conway comes on stage. Have you ever seen the way they act? Scream and holler and jump. Hey,
well, my 12-year-old daughter does the same thing. She asked me the other day what it was that Conway had in his voice that was a growl of some sort. I call it sexy. She calls it a growl. But even she notices it.
Well, tell her this. Ask her if she's ever seen a Conway Twitty doll. He just stands there and goes, But the women, I can't believe. But I'm one of these women too.
And did you ever think you might do duets with him before?
Hey, girl.
Well, yeah.
I guess you're gossiping again.
Hi, Loretta.
Hi.
Hey, Tammy.
Probably gossiping about Conway.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to excuse myself and go back to rehearsal. You've got plenty of company now.
Well, you've been telling Conway stories. I know that, haven't you?
Not really.
Yeah. Listen. You know, there's a great Conway story at Farron, the sheriff, Farron Young, you know, tells
yes.
about him. And said Conway's always been country. He said back in 1956, Conway was doing a rock and roll show up in Canada. So Farron goes up and says, boy, what's your name? He says, Conway Twitty. And Farron says, well, hell, you can't help that. But stop
That's
singing
Farron.
That rock and roll.
That's Farron.
I used to play records on the radio all night at WSM. And Conway would call me from the road. Though he was singing rock, he was listening to country records. And finally, after months of calling me and requesting a tune, he came in one night. Harlan Howard brought him in. Harlan's a great country songwriter, and he brought Conway to my show. I said, you the guy that's been calling me on the telephone at night requesting the rock and roll singer? And Conway said, well, I can sing country. I said, well, I don't believe that. Away from the turntables, we had another microphone in the center of the studio. And I said, Conway, here's the guitar. Sing me a country song. And he sang an old George Jones song called The Window Up Above and just wore it out. And right then, I knew Conway was going to be a big country singer. Loretta, I heard you mention that you met Conway through Owen Bradley. I assume it was Owen's idea for the two of you to sing together.
I think he probably had to, he knew that how... much I loved Conway, and I didn't know at the time, but Conway had told Owen how much that he liked my singing. So I think he either called me to come by, or I went in to just say hello to Owen. And that's how we met. And when we started recording, everybody says, oh my gosh, Conway's not, like you say, not gonna be able to sing country music. He's so rock and roll. Loretta Lynn is so country, I'd like to hear this.
Well, as it turned out, it was probably the most successful duet ever in country music.
What do you mean, probably?
Oh, George, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to leave the trouble with you.
Loretta, yeah. Now, we told Conway stories and we cold Conway stories. I want your biscuit recipe.
You want my biscuit recipe?
Mm-hmm.
All right, first you start out with Crisco.
I agree with you, Tammy. The
songs are very, very important in our business. And the songwriters are sometimes the unsung heroes.
They really are. The song itself, I think, regardless of how great the singer is, unless the song's there, it's just no good.
That's for sure.
You have to have the song. And hey, you guys neither of us have been known as writers.
Interrupt
here. Ralph.
Conway, they've been talking about you behind your back over there.
Who's been talking about me?
Well, Miss Loretta Lynn and George Lindsey and the lady sitting here.
Nice to see you again,
Tammy.
Well, it's good to see you too, Ralph.
If they've been talking about me, I know it's good, so I'm not going to worry about that. We're sitting here talking about good songs, Ralph, and something you know a lot about, and good songwriters.
I have known you and Conway to write good songs.
Well, thank you.
I guess one of my all-time favorite country songs is a song about a girl named Linda.
You like that song?
Could we maybe have a little guitar pulling here?
Yeah, Charley hit me.
Do you remember that song?
Hit me an E. An A is a little too low.
Does he remember this song?
Yeah. Now I'm lying here with Linda on my mind. And next to me, my soon-to-be, the one I left behind. Lord, it's killing me to see her crying. She knows I'm lying here beside her with Linda on my mind.
Yeah, I love that.
Speaking of songwriting, and I know you've had some humongous records, and one of my favorite songs, Till I Can Make It On My Own. I love it. Would you do a little bit of that for me?
I sure will. Key of E flat, I believe.
Oh, I love a song.
I'll need time to get you off my mind. No, sometimes bother you, try to be in touch with you, even ask too much of you from time to time.
Like, who is Linda?
Now and then, Lord, you know I'll need a friend till I get used to losing you. Let me keep on using you till I can make it on my own.
Yeah.
That's it.
Oh, that's beautiful. How do you think of things like that? I mean, what did you do to cause you to hurt that way?
I was asked a question by the other writer, co-writer of this song. If this ever happened to you, what would you do? And I said, are you crazy? It just happened to me. And I'd have to say, till I get used to losing you, let me keep on using you. So we just started working around those two lines.
And when a songwriter sits down and pours himself out or herself out and puts it on that piece of paper and puts it on a record for all of us to enjoy, and we both know what's in it.
You can do it better from the heart if you've written it. If the words come from here, then you can do it better. I can, better than something somebody else has written for me.
I remember all the Conway Twitty fans used to wear little badges right here. They would say, boom, boom, boom.
Oh, yeah.
And that opened a whole new can of nails for you.
Yes, it did. There was a lot of controversy around
it. It was a big hit song.
Well,
it was a good song.
Women liked that song, and that's what saved the day for me. It got rid of all the controversy.
What song are we talking about, Conway?
Well, we'll just show you here. Charley, come here. I can almost hear the stillness as it yields to the sound of your heart beating.
Now, Tammy.
I can almost hear the echo of the thoughts that I know you must be thinking. And as I taste your tender kisses, I can tell you don't love him anymore. Boom, boom, boom.
Are you
as I put my arms around you,
I can tell you never been this far before. One more time. Boom, boom, boom.
Well, that's pretty good.
I'll take this act on the road. Tammy has an amazing range. I don't think people think of her as having an amazing range, but she did a song one time, I think.
Well, you know why, don't you?
Because she let me look so easy.
She just stands there and goes from here to here. Just,
mm-hmm. I may not be the best, but I'm the loudest.
She always sounds like she has a catch in her throat, you know.
She's got a little thing there, you know, that I've...
Well, it's certain words. It's something I can't control. It's just there.
Well, that's good, though. That's what they said to me about that little growl when I first recorded. It's only make-believe. I said, well, what's that? And I said, I don't know what it is.
Just there, but you can't control
and
it.
And it was what helps make Tammy Wynette. And everybody loves.
Thank you.
Yeah, I heard that story one time, Conway, that she really did not like Stand By Your Man.
Well, I'd been doing songs like Kids, I Don't Want to Play House, Divorce, kid-type songs, and this was totally different from anything I'd ever done. And we hadn't even written a song when the session started, and Cheryl said, Billy Cheryl, my producer, said, well, we've got two songs down, let's go write this one, we'll have a third song. So we went upstairs and wrote the song in about 20 minutes, and it had a high note that, to me, was just screaming, and I didn't like it, but through the years, I've learned to love it.
It was a high note, kind of like the Mississippi.
Yeah, like that one we just heard. Yes. But I have learned to love the song.
George, what are you doing here? Every time I come to the Powell House, you're here. What are you doing?
Well, you see, I'm trying to learn how to drive a boat. I mean, this kind of stuff fascinates me. I believe this is a job for me.
Well, I don't know about that, George. I mean, there's a whole lot you got to know about this old river. Yeah. For instance, it flows north and south.
North and south.
And it's got islands.
Islands.
And it turns and it bends.
Yeah.
And it loops back on itself.
Back on itself.
And it's got 950 miles of lights and buoys.
How about lights and girls?
Quirks.
Better than girls, yeah.
It's got a lot of quirks. In fact, more than you can count, because the channels constantly shift from east to west, and then back again.
Back again.
Yeah, you got all that?
Yeah, no problem. Let's see. North, south, bends, loops, islands, shifts, quirks, east, west. Anything else?
Yeah, there's one other thing. There's one more thing my dad told me.
Yeah.
And now you got to be able to name every one of the navigation lights on the river.
No problem, old singer of great songs. I want to tell you, how many is there, 12?
I'd say more like 3,500.
3,500? Well, I better start now. Let's see, there's one out there over by the creek, and there's one over by the...
My pleasure to bring you one of the funniest people I've ever met. As a matter of fact, he's been many things. An actor on Broadway, a school teacher in Alabama, ran a service station in Mayberry, North Carolina, and one of the funniest people on the hit television show, Hee Haw. We've borrowed him for our show tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, you know him as Goober, our friend, George Lindsey.
Thank you. I'm better looking than you thought, ain't I? Hey, lady calls up the fire department. She says, come over quick, my house is on fire. The fireman says, how do we get there? She said, ain't y'all still got that red truck? Oh, I wanted to show you my ring. Isn't that pretty? Huh? See that, Tammy? My mother-in-law passed away and left me some money to get her a stone. I got her a good one, didn't I? Fella goes down to 7-Eleven grocery store. He says to the guy behind the counter, stick him up. He said, stick him up. You got a two before in your hand. He said, that's right, I have. And hit that guy upside the head with that two before. Knocked him down, reached over, took the money out of the cash register, started running out the store. The guy laying on the floor said, come back, come back. He come running back and says, what do you want? The guy on the floor reached his hand in his pocket, pulled out some money and said, here, go buy yourself a gun before you kill somebody with that piece of wood. Fella goes down to the lumber yard. He says, the guy in there, he says, I want to buy some... four by twos. He said, some what? He said, four by twos. He said, we don't have any four by twos. We got two by four by fours, six bys, eight bys, ten bys. Who told you to come in here? He said, the fella driving the truck. He said, go out there and ask him what you want. Comes back, he says, I want some two by fours. He said, how many you want? He said, I don't know. He said, go ask the guy in the truck.
He comes back and he says, how many you want? He says, 198 of them. He said, how long do you want them? He said, we want them a long time. We're going to build a house. A cowboy rides up and he sees two buffalo. And he looks at the buffalo and he said, you're the ugliest animal God ever created. Your nose runs, your head's too big, you got a hump in your back, your behind's too small, and your fur's ratty. Rides off. One buffalo looks at the other one and says, well, now we've heard a discouraging word. I come from what is called uneconomic circumstance. That means we was poor. Well, we wasn't even poor, we wasn't even trash. We used to visit trash on Sundays. I never had a stitch of clothes until I was 7 years old, and on my 7th birthday, my daddy bought me a cap so I could sit at the window and look out. And I've got a dear friend. I come from Jasper, Alabama. I don't know if you've ever been there, but if you just have a year to live, move there. It'll seem like a lifetime. We have two things there, night and day. And I've got a dear friend back there, Sappo, S-A-P-P-O. That's how you pronounce his name. We went to grammar school together, went to junior high school together. We went all through school together, but he's not good looking. If beauty is skin deep, he was born wrong side out. I mean, when he was a baby in the hospital, they used to feed him with a slingshot. I'm telling you, he wasn't pretty, but he had a unique way of looking at things. Because I said to him one day, I said, Sappo, have you lived here in town all your life? He said, not yet. He's down in town one day, he had on one shoe. I said, hey, Sappo, see you lost a shoe. He said, no, I found one. Went out to blacksmith one day, picked up a red hot horseshoe, dropped it. Blacksmith said, burned you, didn't he? He said, no, just don't take me long to look at a horseshoe. He said to me one day, he said, I'm never going to eat eggs again. I said, why not? He said, I went to the grocery store, I bought a dozen eggs, and every one of them had pantyhose in them. Never been on an airplane before, first time. Went up stewardess, he said, pardon me, how high is this plane? She said, it's 40,000 feet. He said, well, my God, how wide is it? Heard a knock on his front door one day. Went to the front door, three men standing there. He said, who are you men? They said, we're the census takers. He said, what do you do? Said, the government has sent us to find out how many people are in the United States. He said, boy, you come to the wrong house. I ain't got the slightest idea. I said, what have you been doing lately? He said, well, a Vaseline salesman come to our house the other day. He said, do you and your wife use Vaseline? We said, yes, we do. He said, what do you use it for? We said, cuts, bruises, and sex. He said, how do you use Vaseline for sex? We said, we put it on the doorknob. It keeps the kids out of the bedroom. I got to go now, but I just want to leave you with one thought for the evening. And that thought is, if you don't think the Lord had a sense of humor, look at the person sitting next to you. Bye-bye, everybody.
Conway, now I know why you love this Mississippi River so well.
Well, I just knew that if I brought you home with me, you'd say just that.
You know, I thought I knew everything about you, but, you know, I've learned a lot about you on this trip. Tell me, what's the greatest thing that's ever happened to you?
Well, I was kind of hoping it hadn't happened yet.
Mississippi, you're on my mind. Mississippi, you're on my mind.